I wanted to show you that we've got one other wall that we're going to be insulating that is not an exterior wall. It is a wall that is bordering, I'll take a walk over here, bordering the storage area of the homeowner's home. All right, back in here we've got the hot water heater, we've got the panel box over there, we've got the furnace, the HVAC system in here. It's a mechanical area, utility area, with all the homeowner's storage stuff. You can see we've got everything covered in nice 6 mil plastic so we don't get drywall dust all over the homeowner's personal belongings. But this room over here is always going to be a cold room. Here's another set of steps down here. They have two sets of steps into this basement, and this set of steps goes right up into a cold garage, and just adding to the coldness down here. So this is going to always remain a cold storage area. So what we have to do is the wall that I'm walking towards now, this wall is the actual wall that's bordering the finished area from the storage area. There's a 36-inch door here we're going to walk through here. This wall I am considering to be an exterior wall. I'm going to treat that wall exactly like I'm treating this wall to my right here that's concrete, that's bordering the outside of the house. This is an exterior wall. We're going to insulate this storage room wall and treat it just like an exterior wall, because we need an insulation barrier between this finished area that I'm standing in right now and that cold storage utility area on the other side of the door there. So anytime you're bordering your storage rooms or your utility areas in your basement, when you're building a wall between the two, treat that wall, that utility wall, as an exterior wall and insulate with the 3.5R13 insulation, just like you are with your exterior walls that are up against the block or the concrete. You just insulate them, and that way when the heat comes on, you're staying nice and warm along that utility wall. Otherwise, if you just treat it as an interior wall, you're always going to have a cold wall and you're going to lose a lot of your heat into the storage area. So insulate all of your storage area walls that border finished areas from storage areas.